What's up, everybody? My name is Lido, and you're watching Stingray PausePlay.
I'm Zach Monson. Welcome back to a very special edition of Stingray PausePlay here with Lido.
How
are you, my friend?
I'm great. How are you?
See you, man. I'm very, very good. You literally just got here.
Yeah, I literally just pulled up right now, five minutes ago.
Walked in, had a snack, came over, so I appreciate you
Priorities, priorities. Stingray is the priority. Yeah, hell yeah.
Over pizza? That's a big deal.
It's right up there. Very close.
So you got your first drum kit at 2, started producing at kind of like 9. Mm-hmm. What was that draw that you just felt like you had to make music?
I think drums is a really smart instrument for kids to get into because you could be a part of the music without having to know all the like the mathematical bullshit
chords,
of it.
Melodies,
exactly.
I was sitting there
and I was like having fun. I was loving the music and like listening to pretty complicated music. And I was like, shit, like around 9 or 10, I realized I want to actually make this stuff and not just like listen to it while playing kind of. So I think I just wanted to create and I didn't know that before I had been a part of the music for a while,
How did your parents' taste in music influence your taste in music?
Majorly. My dad ran a gospel choir when I was a kid.
Amazing.
So gospel music is like the thing that's closest to my heart out of everything.
And that was not part of a church, right? He just ran a gospel choir.
Independent gospel choir that was playing mostly like Baptist church music, and which is obviously not a culture that exists in Norway at all.
Yeah.
So they was like an independent choir that would tour in between churches and like be, you know, about the music mostly. That was really important. My mom was a flute player when she was younger. Both parents big like Steely Dan fans, like Elton John fans. So they definitely influenced me somewhat, but I think gospel was like a very smooth transition into R&B music, which was a smooth transition into hip hop music, which was smoothly into electronic.
Absolutely.
So it kind of just like flowed like that.
And it's funny you say those four things because your music is such a perfect blend all the time of all of those things so nicely together that I think
Thank you.
So what was that first time that you loved music outside of what your parents had kind of shown you?
I think it was the same crazy uncle that bought me the drum kit when I was 2 years old that bought me the College Dropout when I was like 10.
So this is a cool uncle.
He is a very cool uncle. Yeah. Shout out my uncle Bjarte.
Yeah.
That's the boy. Yeah.
It seems like he's doing a good job.
He's killing it. He's responsible for a lot of noise in my house.
Yeah. Yes. Speaking of noise, I heard that you kind of carry around a really good quality microphone that you can plug into your cell phone because you like to capture samples.
Yeah.
What is the best or weirdest sample that you've captured and used?
The weirdest sample? That's a good question. I sampled a bed squeaking once because there's a very famous bed squeaking sample, and I thought I would like try to find like a more HD version of that. I did that one time.
Is there a good story behind the bed squeak, or was it you jumping up and down?
There definitely is a good story, and we're not going to get into it. But so also like I think like bottles popping, like champagne bottles popping, samples. Definitely many a drunk sample that has to do with either like a cup or a bottle or a thing like that. That happens a lot.
We asked the last artist that we had in to ask you a question.
Oh, snap.
The artist is Vance Joy.
Oh, yeah.
And the question is...
Hey, I'm Vance Joy, and my question for you is, what is the best sandwich ingredient?
My favorite sandwich topping must be... Can I say pesto?
You can absolutely say pesto. Absolutely.
Pesto is my shit. Pesto like just makes everything better.
It can go on anything.
Literally everywhere. Makes
that
pasta better.
For sure.
Makes the pizza better. Makes the sandwich better. Pesto. More pesto to the people.
Like it.
Yeah.
So you've spoken a lot about bringing R&B more into electronic music, and not enough. Your new song is just 90s R&B pop dance to the extreme.
Yes.
Now this is slightly off center from your usual kind of sexy future bass kind of thing you have going on. So why the departure?
Just one of those random ideas that we had in the studio. What I've been really into lately is creating samples. So making music that sounds basically going in, making like a 70s song, like an 80s style song or something like that. Then when the song is done, export it, and treat it as a sample, chop it up, absolutely. And make a new song out of that again. So that was the intention of Not Enough. Yeah. We were kind of just messing around making songs that we figured we were going to sample.
Yeah.
And then the song turned out really cool, and we were like, you know what? Fuck it. We're just going to put it out and just have fun. No real plan behind it. It was just like a crazy idea in the middle of the night.
It's awesome.
Yeah.
And the music video was so bright and fun and dancey. Tell me about filming that. I mean, you're dancing on top of a box by yourself. Is that a comfort zone for you, or is that awkward?
Definitely not. And you can tell by the dancing, it's quite awkward stuff, but a lot of fun. And I dance a lot by myself, but usually not in front of cameras.
Or on a box.
Yeah, definitely not on boxes. Not on boxes. On tables a lot, and on chairs and on things like that, but not on boxes. That was a new thing.
Do you have a go-to dance move when you're out?
I have a couple, most of my dancing happens either in my shoulders or my feet. Everything in between is kind of still. Yeah. So like there's a lot of stuff happening here and then there's a lot of stuff happening this. Everything in between, I have no idea what's going on.
I love it. Now, you seem to always be working on new music. Mm-hmm. What can you tell me about your new song, U-Turn?
Whoa. That was a very, what? How?
I mean, if you want to share anything at all with me about that song, I would love to know.
I'm kind of flabbergasted. I didn't know you knew anything about that song. Some of the best journalism that has ever happened to me, and like dead ass in the middle of an interview. Like, wow, that song is not even completed, not even close to completed yet. You killed it.
I know.
Well, shit, I don't know what's going to happen to that song, but I write songs every day, and there's a lot of music happening. I'm very deep in like the next album already, so hopefully.
And when can we expect that? And will it be a slight departure? Is it going to be more 90s dance-ish, or is it going to be more of the sexy stuff that you've been doing in the past?
I think I try to make everything a departure. I would like the reason for you to pay attention to what I do with the Lido project being you have no idea what the next thing is going to be.
Yeah.
So I try to keep that up and do weird things and surprising things every time. The only thing I can really say about the next project is that it will be much more vocal heavy.
Yeah.
I'll be singing a lot more.
Awesome.
But other than that, who knows? It could go in a lot of directions.
Well, look, man, whatever it is, I have no doubt it'll be fantastic, because if it's anything like what you've done in the past, it will be just that. So I really appreciate you talking, man. I'm very excited to hear the music.
Thank you, man.
You can hear Lido, Lido, Lido on Stingray Music's Eclectic Electronic channel, and of course, all of our Stingray Music's Vibes channels available now on our mobile app and our web player. Don't forget to leave us a thumbs up, a comment, and subscribe for all the next episodes of Pause Play. See you next time, guys.
Woo-wee.